Hey, what's happening? Jason Mugg, ACSLive.tv, on board the battleship here in Muskegon, the TST. TST, what's the name of the ship, sir? LST 393. Stop it, Dave.
I'm horrible. My brain's already asleep.
Right. Yeah.
I'm sure I got another 4 years left in me, but hey.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's not a battleship.
What is that, a light?
It's a long, slow target, if you were a Navy man, or it means landing ship tank. That one time on D-Day, there was 28 Shermans on this tank deck.
Wow.
Getting ready to hit the beach.
Packed in here?
Omaha Beach, yep.
Wow.
And then the whole top deck was loaded.
Sweet. You got you hooked up? Good.
Yep, you're all hooked up there.
Right on.
Are we already? Oh, okay, you're already.
Yeah. You're recording right now.
I'm gonna get hooked up on the power. What a, it should be cool.
I didn't bring.
Hey, sure.
automatically charged you.
Where the semifinals took place. I'll go over this fight card before we introduce who's on the dais with me today. Starting off tonight in the flyweight division, we have Mike Dunbar, who is here at the table, taking on Mike Myers. And moving to the super flyweight division at a catchweight 130, Cody Wiseman is also up here at the table, taking on Ben Neese. In the featherweight division, Herman Evelock is at the table with me today. We'll be taking on Brian Ezekiel. The lightweights, neither one present today. Matt Mills taking on the A-Train, Anthony Wilson. Moving to the junior welterweight division at 165 pounds. Thrusted, Justin Overton. Taking on Todd Holstich in that fight. The welterweight division, Sean Anutai. Taking on Josh Zimmer. August 14th. And then both gentlemen in the middleweight division are present here at the press conference. Lee Searsma taking on Dougie Whitener. Moving up to the light heavyweight division, Chet Kinner, who is present on the dais, will be taking on Phil Wilson. Moving on to the heavyweight division, Dylan Ompey taking on Gilbert Reyna. Your super heavyweights, Downtown Company's own Brent Martin. taking on Joe Commodore, perhaps one of the most anticipated super heavyweight matchups in state history. And rounding out the night, main event, present to my left and your right, Sean Rosenkrantz. Going to be trying to take that belt home as he faces Brandon Emmons. Trying. Tickets are on sale now. General admission is $15. Get your VIP ticket and put you right in the action for $20. You can get these at the Berlin Raceway website or ticket office. The best way to get tickets is from your favorite fighter. It's one of the few ways that amateurs can earn money to continue your training and putting on a show for everybody that does come to watch. And their website is www.berlinraceway.com. And before we open up the question, how about everybody here present? Give a round of applause for everyone that does show up to a press conference. That should be noted that in amateur MMA, these gentlemen do have to go to work, and we do thank them for their time. Let's open it up for questions. Who are you?
Jason Mung, ACS Live. Sean, you come into the MMA world like thunder, and now you're in the Berlin Belt Championship Series. You're on your last night of fights coming up, and you actually get to take the belt home, and you don't have to defend that. How does that feel different between something you have to constantly going through a championship series and possibly coming out on top of that?
For me, it's just, it's going to be another trophy for my collection. Hopefully, if all goes planned, everything that I've trained for and everything. In reality, it's all about, for me, it's about just who I'm fighting. The belt has a little bit to do with it, but for me, it's not the belt. It has nothing to do with the belt. As for me to be growing to be a bigger fighter, and facing these people. This is a great attribute to KOP for this. All these great fighters that are in the series. And if you win the series, it's like, yeah, that's what's up. Battle for another winner. And I would like to add that to my repertoire.
Nice. Thank you.
Thank you, Jason. PCS Live. Ben
from Atlanta. For anyone who wants to answer this question, sure. In your amateur pursuits of trying to become pro with an MMA fighter, you guys have fought on the death of abortion, war on abortion. First time ever, Dave.
First time ever. How's it feel?
Let's go right on now.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that's right. You know what, dude? None of these guys are fighting tonight. This is awesome.
He is.
Oh, you are, really?
He is.
Jimmy, go right ahead and let him answer that one.
Okay. First time ever.
Yes, I'm the most dad. First time.
Yeah.
I don't even think the UFC is that fun. That would be a negative. This might be the first time in all of MMA that anybody's fighting
on MMA, baby.
KOP, baby.
First time. KOP, baby.
Hey!
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 Hey! Hey! Are any fans press in the house? Raise your hand if you have a question for anybody specific. Or not. That's just fine. I'm going to go right on down the line here for everybody that can take the time to show up. Give you guys a chance to address the press and the crowd. Tell us a prediction or how you feel going into this final on August 14th. Whatever you want to say, it's your turn. So we'll start with Dougie Leitner.
I'd just like to thank everybody for coming out to support us. Come out to the show. Judge, we're gonna go to war with everybody. It's, you know, it's been a long time coming. We grew up wrestling each other. We always be getting wrestled on it. It's time to fight some folks. Play me the best man to win and come out better friends and families. Somebody's gonna be evil, but come out like that.
Alright, thank you again, Dougie Whitener. We'll be facing Lee Sears, but in the middleweight final. One of these belts is going home with 22, and I'm going to move right to you, Lee, since he got to go. You guys are the only two that are competing against each other on August 14th. Why don't you rebut whatever you'd like to say? You can predict what you want to see. Tell everybody how it feels to have made it through to the finals or anything.
I'm just saying, like, that's very worried. We're all wrestling. Going out to almost go to the cage.
Dougie's opponent Lee Sears, none of these guys will be getting out on August 14th at the Berlin Raceway. Battle for Berlin Bell Finals. Herman Hempelhoff, your featherweight finalist. Go ahead and address the crowd on predictions. Anything you want?
Well, I'm kind of mad Ryan's not here. I can't talk about smack. But no, thank you guys for coming out. Everybody's here at the show. It's just going to be another one. He's just another person to win. I'm just seeing their first round finish. He's pretty good. He's pretty athletic. He does a lot of spinning stuff. But
so once he spins, he's going to spin and knock
you down. He's going to be like a top. You know, once he gets taken down, he's going to be like a fish out of water.
Moving down the dais, we have Cody Wiseman, a super flyweight finalist at 130 pounds, taking on Ben. Nice.
Let's get that wrong.
Nice. All right, Cody, any predictions for what we're going to see in that super flyweight contest?
It's going to be a war, you know. I'm going to go out and show up on the scene, you know. And I'm going to take the belt. There's a lot of people without me, you know. So, I love it.
And second fight of the night in the super flyweight division, Cody Wiseman. Going up against Ben Nias. And kicking off the night at the very end, of the far end of the table, flyweight is going to be the first fight of the night, taking on Mike Myers, Mr. Mike Dunbar. What can we expect for you guys kicking off the evening?
It's going to be exciting. I mean, everybody keeps talking about these belts like they're something, but everybody from Asperia has enough accolades. They don't need it anymore. None of us want to stay here. We're all moving forward. I mean, they're going to be good fights. We're all right.
And then at 6:30, you'll wrap this press conference up with pictures. Anybody wants to feel free and come up and address these gentlemen for a few minutes, get some pictures for whatever, or more personal questions for any of the press. Feel free to do so. Oh yeah, get that microphone warmed up so everybody can get loud tonight.
Devin Dan. Him and Tyron.
Casey Price. Jeremy Kraft. Luke Spots. Derek Dildine.
Nope.
Hunter Liberty.
Huh? That's the greatest name for a fighter I've ever heard.
Kenneth Cross.
Say that again.
Hunter Liberty.
Yeah, dude.
Woo! Dude, we could make it. Hunter Liberty. It'd be great.
Okay. That look like I'll catch you.
Kenneth Cross.
There.
Desmond Colvin. Todd Roberts.
Somewhere within, I think they down.
Those just fuckers,
down and
Mike,
away.
Jake, Burgess.
Well, I do know that they both
know the hey, yeah, they do. Jake's right there.
Is that everybody?
You didn't call my name.
I got it.
Yeah, all right, everyone.
I already saw him.
Listen up real quick. Move in so I don't have to yell, please. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over the fouls. And okay, I know a lot of you guys have reffed you before, so it won't be a big deal. All the fights are going to be 3 3-minute rounds, except for the grappling match. And I will talk to the guys that are grappling as soon as I'm done with this. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over the fouls real quick. What I'm going to do is tell you what you cannot do. So if I don't say that you cannot do it, then you can do it. Okay? That easy. There's no holding or grabbing the fence. Treat the fence as a wall. You can post your hands on it. You can post your feet on it. As soon as your finger or toes go through the fence, that is illegal. You cannot do that, okay? So you cannot grab it. If you grab the cage to stop a takedown, if I believe that your opponent was going to get a takedown, I will take a point from you. If you... I thought somebody just said why. If you grab the cage to change positions, I will put you back in the position. So let's say you're mounted and you grab the cage and you pull yourself up, I will put you back on the ground. Okay, are there any questions about grabbing the cage? You cannot hold your opponent's gloves or shorts. You can hold your own gloves, you can hold your own shorts. You cannot grab a hold of anything your opponent is wearing, okay? Pretty simple. There's no headbutting at all. You cannot strike with your head. You can post with it, but you cannot strike with it. Clear? Not to the head, not to the body, nowhere. There's no eye gouging of any kind. So you cannot stick your fingers, your chin, your elbow, anything. Do not put anything in someone's eye, okay? I had a trouble at the last fight here. A guy was gauging his range. Instead of sticking his jab out like this, he was sticking his hand out. He stuck his fingers in the guy's eyes. Don't do that, okay? Close your fists. There's no biting or spitting at your opponent, no pulling the hair, no fish hooking. That's sticking your fingers in someone's mouth. You cannot attack the groin at all. You cannot intentionally place your finger into any orifice. Any hole on the body is an orifice, okay? Do not stick anything into any hole on the body, including a cut. If you cut someone, don't stick your fingers in it, okay? We're using elbows, all right? Does anyone have a problem with elbows? I need to know right now. Okay, if you come to the cage and tell me you don't want to throw elbows, I'm going to tell you tough, because you already told me you wanted to. So, the only elbow you cannot throw is reaching straight up to the sky and coming straight down, okay? Any kind of angle on it is fine, any kind of arc is fine. If you're on your back, yes, you can spike to the head, because it's not from the sky to the floor, okay? So, if the full mount, you can strike down.
From the full mount, you can throw down. You cannot do this, okay? Do not go straight up and come straight down. Clear? Okay. No small joint manipulation. Make sure you grab at least three fingers when every one of you is in a guillotine choke.
Or toes.
Okay? Or toes. Make sure you grab three fingers. If you're in a guillotine choke and you grab one finger, I'm going to put you back in the choke. Alright? So don't do it. No heel strikes to the kidneys. If you have someone in your guard, do not strike them to the kidneys with your heels. You can hit them anywhere else, the ass, the legs, anything, that's fine. You cannot intentionally attack the throat. Okay, if you want to post on the neck, that's fine. Do not grab. Hand has to be wide open. Do not grab the collarbone or anything like that. Do not strike the throat at all.
Luke Spots, Deontay Smith, Derek Dildine, when you guys are done with us, you need to come back. We need to get finished with the medic.
Yep.
Okay, there's no pinching, clawing, any of that shit, okay? No kicking or kneeing the head of a downed opponent. A downed opponent is anything other than my 2 feet touching the ground. As soon as a knee goes down, a finger goes down, anything else goes down, now I am down. You cannot knee or kick the head. You will lose a point if you do that, okay? If you kick your fighter or knee your fighter in the head when they're on the ground, If they can't continue, you're going to lose. So be careful, okay? The only time it's gonna make a difference is when Cody shoots on me from way out there and he touches the ground, I can knee him in the face because it's initial forward motion. I cannot stop him and then knee him, okay? As long as it's had initial forward motion. Any questions about grounded opponent?
Good. Accidental slips.
Accidental.
They come in like however you said it, or they try to dodge and you accidentally catch them. You're not gonna get abduction. I don't understand.
He's saying if they
go to like try to maneuver to say for instance get away from a cross or anything like that, but then you bring a knee in, they're like halfway down if already in motion.
Oh no.
As long as you didn't touch
that's
the first
time. Yeah. They have to be established. So by established I mean you have to be down. If you're this guy that does this and you get kicked in the face, tough shit. If you wanna be down, get down. If you wanna be up, stay up. Okay?
Also 90 degrees of the cage.
I don't do that. Okay. All right.
Good.
No stomping a grounded opponent. Once someone's on the ground, you cannot stomp them. This comes into play with axe kicks. If you want to throw an axe kick, know what you're doing. Your leg has to be locked out, up and down. As soon as your knee bends, it's a stomp, which is illegal. Okay? Timidity. Okay, if you're being timid in the fight, I will warn you. Timidity means you're not engaging in the fight. If you're constantly running from your opponent, if you're turning your head and covering up against the cage, you can't do that. You guys are in there to fight. If you're being timid, I will take points from you. I may end the fight. No interference from the seconds. The last show that I did for these guys is the first time that I ever took a point away from a fighter because of a corner man. If you're a corner man and you look at me and tell me that I'm doing a bad job and I can fuck off, your fighter's gonna lose a point. Okay? Corner man, make sure your fighter has water, has a mouthpiece, has a cup and a way to keep it in place. Have a towel for them. Keep your fingers out of the cage and stay in your seats. Don't talk back to me, okay? If you have a problem with what I'm doing, I'm more than happy to talk to you after the fight, but if you're cage side screaming at me, it's not gonna do your fighter any good, okay? And I'll be happy to talk to anyone after the fight. No throwing your opponent out of the cage. Okay, no spiking your opponent on their head. You cannot grab your opponent, turn them upside down, and spike them on their head. Okay? You can if you're in an arm bar. He has control of his body. You can jam their head in the ground. That's fine because they can let go. If you're in a triangle, you can pick them up and slam them. That is fine. If you want to suplex somebody, that is fine. Those are all ways that someone could get spiked on their head, which is okay. But you cannot have control of someone's body, okay? I cannot grab Dave, turn him upside down, and jab him on his head. Okay? If you do that, it's going to be an automatic disqualification. All right? No attacking your opponent after the bell, all that simple stuff. Any questions about anything, guys? Anything at all? You sure? Cool. Whoever needs to get their medicals done needs to go back there because we're going to get started.
Hey, guys, stay here for a sec.
I need to talk to the grapplers.
Yeah. Only the grapplers? Cody and Devin, everybody else stay here for a second. Hey, come here. If you guys need gauze and tape, come find me. If you need gloves, come find me. If you have your own gloves, come find me. Okay? Because I got to check all your gloves. We got to make sure they're the right size. We're going to have Vance look at them. I'm going to look at them. Everything like that. Just to make sure everybody's on an even playing field here, all right?
Thanks. Hey, since we're here, so I'm